Yo, gonna wait for one person to join before going into it. Nope. Woo, we got some people. What up, HyperChange? I'm back on live. Just got off of Cheddar. I'm processing one of the craziest Tesla news days in Tesla history, which is definitely saying something. So this is what I'm gonna run through the history of what went down today, and then we're gonna digest the analysis. Okay, so basically what's going on here is earlier this morning, it was announced that the Saudi Arabian government had taken about a $2 billion stake in Tesla, representing between 3 to 5% of the company. This was huge news, validates what myself and a lot of Tesla bulls have been thinking for quite some time, which is that there's so many huge entities, whether it's the Saudi Arabian government or, Tencent or the SoftBank Vision Fund or Apple or Amazon or Alphabet, Waymo. I think all of these larger players would love to get a piece of Tesla. The story is that it's not that they can't raise money and they're desperately going bankrupt, it's that they don't want to raise money. And that was validated today when they got the investment from the Saudis. So that's how the day started. Then, next thing that happens, bam, Elon Musk tweets. Insane. I'm considering taking Tesla private at 420, funding secured. Huge, appropriately breaks the internet. I mean, this is it totally took me by surprise, and I was totally blown away by this. So I want to find my tweet here, because then Elon Musk actually replied to me, and so then immediately after this news, I tweeted, "No, still processing what this means, but would be sad to see all the investors who've been with Tesla miss out on the upside over the next few years. Although if this helps the mission and Elon thinks it's smart, I understand and fully support." So my gist was here, like, wow, I'm stoked. Tesla buyout at 420, $73 billion. That's the highest it's ever been. Everybody who's invested cashes out with a huge profit. It would screw over all the shorts, all the haters, all the people betting against Tesla would be proven wrong. Feel good story, but I was frustrated because we'd be missing out along the ride. I do not want to sell my Tesla stock at 420. I think this is going so much higher, and that is why I tweeted that at Elon, like, "Hey, look, this is great, but all the little guys who've been with you since day one are going to miss out on the ride from 420 a share to 4,200 a share if you go private." But then Eli's total game changer to me. "My hope is all current investors remain with Tesla, even if we're private, would create special purpose fund enabling everyone to stay with Tesla. Already do this with Fidelity Space Estimate." Huge news. So this basically means that if you're holding Tesla stock and this buyout deal goes through, you will actually have the option to A, either sell out at 420 or hold in this new sort of private entity that you will be able to liquidate at certain periods. Now, a ton of you guys have been asking, like, "How would I be able to sell my stock eventually if I take stock in this new private company?" There's probably gonna be a ton of different time liquidation scenarios. For example, companies like SpaceX that are very large and private have a ton of employees with stock options they'd like to liquidate, often have this thing where, like, every 3 to 6 months, SpaceX will coordinate a sale of its equity and you can get into that sale at a certain price. So there will still be a chance to sell if you own stock in this new private entity, but it'll probably be a lot less frequently with a lot less liquidity. That brings me to my biggest point and sort of still disappointment, even through all this news, of why Tesla's going private. I love the transparency of the public markets. The financial statements are public. They have to do SEC filings. They have to do the conference calls where we can ask questions. They're open sourcing one of the most fascinating business case studies of all time, which is Tesla. And I think that's amazing. And I love being able to witness it. I think so many people learn from it. I think having a liquid market where you can buy and sell and price your stock every day is the future. We're in the digital era. You can tweet 24/7. Your stock should be trading 24/7, not every 6 months because you're private. So I think I want to see companies go public. And it would be sort of a sad thing because if Tesla sort of caves on this and they go private, because that would mean, like Tesla's one of the most exciting disruptive companies in the world, and more and more of today's exciting disruptive companies aren't going public and they don't allow the little guy to invest, and that's super sad to me. And I think Tesla would cement that trend by themselves going private. So I want them to stay public. Part of me thinks this, maybe Elon's Twitter's hacked. I don't think that's true, but and this also could just be like a flex move where Elon's like, "Hey, if you're shorting our stock, this is what you got to realize. The Saudis are willing to give us billions of dollars. I could take Tesla out for 420 tomorrow. There's $70 billion worth of capital to do that. It's secured." It could just be Elon flexing there. But judging by his Twitter statements, I don't think he is. I mean, right now, as I'm recording this, the stock is at 367 per share. It's 3:16 p.m. As you can see, the stock was going like this, bam, Elon tweets, it starts hitting. I mean, and then the stock goes up and now they've halted it. News is pending. So like literally at any moment, we could be getting the official word on what is happening from Tesla. I mean, this is absolutely mind blowing. And there's been a couple more tweets with by Elon, who's basically saying like, we're appreciative of Tesla shareholders, we'll ensure their prosperity in every scenario. So like, if you wanna stay on board with Tesla, even if this buyout happens, you'll be able to keep your stock. He was on just to elaborate very recently, about 10 minutes ago, definitely no forced sales, hope all shareholders will remain, will be way smoother and less disruptive as a private company, ends negative propaganda from shorts. So it's we can all hold, but Elon, negative propaganda from shorts, like that's what's making you take this private? I don't know. I just kind of wish Elon had like, maybe like, I don't know if this is right for me to say, but like a little bit thicker skin to just be like, screw the shorts. We're going to dominate anyway. Who cares? Like when I post videos on YouTube, a bunch of people comment making fun of me and they're haters, whatever. I just ignore them. I'm not going to stop posting on YouTube because of that. I don't know. So I just hope that the media and short propaganda isn't really what's driving this, because that would be sad. So anyway, I've got to end this live video soon so I can save it and post it on YouTube. Don't want it to be too long. I'm going to be doing a ton more live videos because this is just like really, really fun. So yeah, questions, comments. Well, I'm going to try wave back to some of you guys. Will you be keeping all of your stock if this bout happens? Yes, I've said that a couple times. Of course I'm keeping. You think I'm selling at 420 per share? Not a chance. James Neary, what up, cuz? Just went on Cheddar. I'm going to try and post that on HyperChange later. Mark Spiegel is going bonkers. He blocked me on Twitter, so I can't even follow him. Do shareholders have to accept? No. You'll have the right to hold on to your shares if you want. There'll be a vote. Elon doesn't have a controlling interest. The board's going to have to approve this, no doubt. Any more questions, comments? Or should I just post this video to the HyperChange YouTube channel? Nothing? All right, well, HyperChangers, you are all awesome. Maybe I'm gonna have to go on live in another 30 minutes here if we actually get this news. Actually, before I end this video, I'm gonna do one like refresh of Elon's Twitter because you never know these days. All right, that looks like it's it. Would this affect his incentive package? I don't think so. I wonder if the buyer is Apple or the Sones Fund. I don't know what the Sones Fund is. Apple could definitely do it. Anyway, you guys are all awesome. Sending ton of love to the HyperChange community, all the Tesla fans out there. You guys are awesome. Gonna do way more live videos going on. Maybe I'll just like wake up every morning and like with my coffee, just have a live video. We'll chat it up about the news. Gonna be awesome. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time. This is HyperChange. Peace.